How do you get faster in a sword fight? Hello there, Martin here from Schildwache Potsdam. This video is about body mechanics and it's largely inspired by a presentation of Robert Geisler, who held this presentation about physics in sword fighting on their recent Fechtschule event. Okay, first up, on a little side note, of course, if you want to get faster in a sword fight, athleticism always helps. Just remember, technique amplifies your natural fitness, so doing the actual work, the actual training always will help you in any kind of fight. But, of course, technique is also important. So the hypothesis, or one of the hypotheses of Robert's presentation was that the shortest path is not always the quickest. And for that, he told a story, but like if you want to drive from point A to point B, there might be several ways you can go. And the shortest one might be one that leads you off-road. And because you have to go slower there, it might not be the quickest all in all. So taking a little reasonable detour to get on a highway might lead you to a quicker path overall. And the second hypothesis is that our body doesn't move in straight lines actually. So while several medieval masters tell you to get your point into the enemy like it's on a line and drawn towards the target on the most direct path, it's quite a bit more complicated than that actually. Because, let's make an example, if we start in Porta di Ferro Stretta or in a flug-like position and we want to thrust to the opponent, so like Langort, then there are actual several movement parts here that work together. Let's break it down. A bit oversimplified, we can say that our body moves around our joints in circular motions. So for instance, I could rotate my arm around my shoulder, and to get the point online again, in the same motion, I could rotate my hand around my wrist to get that point straight forward. So would that be the quickest motion we can get? No, probably not, because that motion, if you just look at the shoulder component, it pretty much looks like a pizza slice. You know why I call this a pizza slice? It's because I practice Italian swordsmanship, of course. But this pizza slice takes a little detour, you know? So what could we do to make this movement a bit faster? Well, for now, if we just do this pizza slice, we just engage our shoulder muscles. We could use other muscles to deload the shoulder muscle, to support it. For instance, we could bend at our elbow, we could engage our biceps to deload the shoulder while still lifting the shoulder up towards the opponent. So this movement of the shoulder should now be quicker. And before we get there, so while the shoulder moves up, we again extend our arm. So we engage our triceps and use this extension of our arm to get our hand from A to B on the quickest path. It's not the most direct, so it's not the pizza slice, of course, but it's also not a straight line, because that would be kind of awkward. But it's more like a lift up and straight towards the opponent. Okay, because the first part of this movement is actually the hardest one and our shoulder muscle is pretty small. So we want to get all the help of the rest of the body we can get. So for instance, for the thrust, it's engaging the biceps while lifting up the shoulder. So this gets easier. And then while lifting up the shoulder, still this movement, we extend again our arm. Okay, another example. For instance, the reverso ridoppio are the rising strike from our left. There are several components. First, we probably don't want to make a huge detour. Why could a huge detour be of use? Well, because just getting to our goal as quickly as possible is not the only thing we are looking out for. Because if, especially with cuts, we look for a certain final velocity, because especially with cuts, they are meant to cut, to strike. And if we are just, for instance, with the same motion, turn around the point of our sword, then this motion will have little cutting power. But it certainly gets the hand, the probably most important component of this motion, very fast to the final destination. Okay, so what we don't want to do is we don't want to take a big detour. So we don't want to pull this thing back and then get to the final velocity in a quick manner. This is a big motion, it's a big tempo, and while the final velocity of this motion is high, so you could deliver a powerful cut actually, it's a big motion, a big tempo, and leaves you open for a long time, especially in the first part of this motion, where probably masters like Giovanni della Gocchia would advise your opponent to hit you in the hands while you do this lift of the hand, for instance. Okay, what do you want to do instead? Well, we want to get to a good final velocity, but it doesn't have to exceed the velocity too much. So we just want to cut with it, and then the most important component is to get there as quickly as possible. So what could we do? We could again raise our arm while we lift the shoulder. So again, engage our biceps. And while we do this, we turn the hand as well. Okay, so it's still, just from looking at it with our hand, we can get some additional speed at the end with the extension of our arm. So it's not just the raising of our shoulder, of our arm itself, but it's also the extension of our arms that adds to it. And heck, if you're really into this, you could, of course, and you should, use the rotation of your body. So the rotation of your body can add to the final velocity of your cut as well. So it's basically three motion components. The first one is bending your arm while lifting the shoulder. That's the second one. And the third one is the rotation of your body. Okay, and if you look at this motion closely, it's not going back, but it still moves the hand in a fairly direct manner to the target. And it's still the bending of the arm and raising of the shoulder at the same time. So, some takeaways. Our hand needs to move, okay, from point A to point B. And this should be conducted in the most direct manner that is possible, that leaves you with enough final velocity to make your attacks count. Okay, so there's no use if you're here and you want to cut like a left middle hao or a reverso tondo, and that's just that. This will not do anything. But if you're in the same motion, use your hip well and use the rest of your body well, you can do this hand motion in the most direct manner while still generating enough power. And for that, you need to think about the muscle groups you can engage, okay? And the most prominent ones are, like I said, the shoulder, biceps, triceps, and even the underarm if you want to rotate your sword around the plane of the flat. But the resulting motion is probably not a direct line of your hand or even of the tip of the sword, but it's a little bit more complex than that. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Remember, Leave a like and share it with a friend if you enjoyed it. And until next time, ciao.